welcome to everybody. It's my sheer pleasure and privilege to welcome all of you at the inaugural Mint Annual Wealth Creators Summit. What we are seeing in India right now, that families and first-generation entrepreneurs are at least beginning to have a conversation about selling their businesses. In fact, 2 weeks back, I was talking to a private equity investor in a large global PE fund, and he was telling me that entrepreneurs have a realization now that you can still become a star after selling your business. Of course, there are parallels being drawn to the likes of Ajay Piramal and the Singhs of Ranbaxy, who got so much of media love and attention after selling their businesses. And that's precisely what this event is all about. So we begin our first panel with Inherited Wealth. So we'll begin straight with Abhimanyu. You carved out Hero FinCorp from the Hero family, you know, just not necessarily into financial services business. Was it the easy part of going and telling the family that, okay, look, this is what I want to do? And what really were the boundaries set up in your conversations with them?
So it's never easy when you go to a family council and ask for money, right? The dilemma in a family council is, like a lot of investment councils, where it's very objective, where there are no emotions. In a family council, you'll always see emotions come in. For me, I think it was perseverance. I've always wanted to get into financial services, and have been after my family for maybe since 2010, maybe even a couple of years before that. But my granddad always used to say, that's not our core business. Let's put our money in machines. We understand motorcycles. Once the family got convinced, till date, we've got small investments. And their confidence has increased after the first year's performance, and then so on and so forth.
And how was this conversation around roping in an external investor, which families are not really open about it?
In 2015, when I required, since I'm in the financial services, my raw material is cash, I required more growth capital. I said, why shall I go back to the family again? Let me validate what I'm doing. And let me prove not only to myself, to my stakeholders, that the company is ready and where they have invested, the thesis is coming to be true. So that's why we convinced the family that we should get external capital. We don't want to be drinking our own Kool-Aid. We wanted a validation, and we wanted thought partners. And I've had a great experience with my investors over the last 6 months. We got a round in September 2015. So I think we are pretty happy with that.
Interesting. I'll sort of not come to you, Amit. You know, I mean, you sold Putney Computers, which was really the pioneer of the IT services back then, and you sold it to iGate, which was a company much smaller your size. When you look back, is there any regret in sort of selling it back then? If you look at the condition of IT services now?
You know, it was quite emotional for my father and my uncles, because I always tell everyone that we created a technology startup 35 years back in 1970s. So we were the pioneers in setting up a IT outsourcing company. And it was typical startup, like today what we have startups. I think when we started getting offers for a strategic sale, and you know, there are many private equity players here who are going to speak in the next panel, and it happens where the private equity wants to get a better value by strategic exit. And it was quite an emotional decision for my father and my uncles.
So Amit, why not getting into entrepreneurship again? I mean, you made a lot of money, I mean, the family, after selling Putney Computers. I remember clearly it was the largest deal in the IT space. But you chose to back companies. Why not foray into entrepreneurship yourself?
So I think, you know, I had worked with the family business for, you know, since after graduation. Almost 22, 23 years. And I felt that why not bring my value add and my experience to help other startups. And when we sold our company, it was 2011, where India was just entering in the phase of, you know, we were only 30 million internet users, maybe 100, 200 mobile subscribers. I found that this is the right time to help startups and there's going to be phenomenal opportunities rather than, you know, again getting into operating businesses and then sort of struggling. So
Amrita, sir, you and your life cycle at Wolcott Hospitals, the family also went through that. You know, how was that, you know, entire journey when the family went through that? Can you perhaps take us through that?
From a management point of view, I think what we tried to do is, it was more of a financial issue which we had at that time. Fundamentals of the business were doing well. So from an operational point of view and profitability point of view of the business part of it, that was doing very well. So in that way, it was good. So business-wise, I think two, three things we did at that point of time. One is we identified in our group and in the organization what is core to our business and what is not core. So some of the non-core businesses that we had, we divested during that period of time. We got some liquidity into the system. It helped in deleveraging the debt that we had. So that was one thing that we did. Second is we focused on our operational, which was healthy. Fundamentally, our operation was healthy. So we continued our focus on that. And I think, by and large, we just did these two things. And in a short time, we were able to restructure the debt on one hand and come out of the entire CDR.